In this corner, weighing his 10-year-old nephew's hand-me-downs, all the way from scared husband Ali, the one and only Jared, the man-child Scheinberg. And in this corner, weighing... Don't ask your partner how much they weigh. All the way from the capital of Amright America, Jared's partner.
Fight!
Use I statements when expressing how you feel.
I feel when you...
Communicating with I statements keeps the focus on how you feel and what specifically is bothering you. Conversely, using you statements such as, "You make me so mad, you should know better," places blame on your partner and often creates more conflict and arguing. If you use a you statement, start warming up the car. Avoid calling your partner insulting names.
Hey, you forgot to take out the garbage again. Speaking of garbage, your breath be stank.
Hurling insults at your partner is aggressive and digs at their own self-worth. Instead, it's healthier to name the behavior that upsets you and to insult that.
You're a great person, but you fold laundry like a blind octopus.
Also, I know it's tempting, but avoid classic insulting phrases such as, "I know you are, but what am I?" "Talk to the hand," and "nanny nanny poo poo." If you can't remain calm during an argument, have a safe word. Sometimes in the heat of the moment, emotions escalate, and it's better to take a break, walk away, and fantasize about how good things were when you first met. Come back and talk about the issue when things have calmed down. However, just walking away from the argument without saying anything could be interpreted by your partner as being dismissive and could result in more anger. Thus, agree on a safe word that the both of you can use. If needed, use the safe word during an argument to signal to the other person that you respectfully have to take a break from the argument before it gets out of hand. A safe word could be anything the two of you agree on, including my favorites, help, fire, run, stop. Focus on one issue at a time. It could be tempting to start an argument with your partner because they didn't open the car door for you, and then list all the ways in which your partner is disrespectful. And then you start blaming your partner's behavior on his or her mother's bad parenting skills, using some traditional yo mama jokes. "Yo mama's so irresponsible, she raised you!" But you're not going to solve all of your problems in one argument. It's too overwhelming to bring up too many issues at once. It's best to solve one issue at a time. Drawn out year after year after year after... Remain respectful. I know having respect for your partner seems obvious, but people forget. So much so that it had to be spelt out in a song. Due to copyright infringement laws, let's pretend that Jared is listening to Aretha Franklin's song. Like this video? Be sure to subscribe.